You looking for trouble, bud? I got plenty to spare, so watch your ass around me. You want to know what I do, bud? Anything I fucking want. I'm one of a kind. I've been places, see? And done things. Lots of them. And when it's time to kill shit up, hell yeah, I'm a fucking storm of death. Something or someone make the mistake of crossing Ricky, I'll fucking dead-eye him, her, or it. In fact, that's my nickname. Deadeye Ricky. That's my name. How you think? I shoot things in the eye. That's how good I am. Yeah, I'm that good. Why, once I got jumped by 3 death jaws. Except, actually, it was 4 of them. Imagine that. But I didn't panic. Because I never panic. What I did was become a storm of death. Shot every one of them monsters pop in the eye. No, you heard me right. Death jaws. They're like death claws, but bigger teeth. Or there was the time one of them Steel Brotherhood assholes made the mistake of messing with me. Last mistake he ever made. What's it sound like I'm saying? If I was saying what you said I was saying, then yeah, I said it. I was walking along, minding my own, and up pops one of them brotherhoods. He yells, "Hand over that laser rifle, asshole!" So I hand it over, just to make him think I'm scared. But really, I'm not. I never am. Before he knows what hit him, I draw my 11mm machine gun, and bam, bam, right through the eye slit in his helmet. DOA. There so is. Or was it a 9mm? Or a 10? I don't know. Don't care. Said I was good at killing shit up. Never said I was good with numbers. I travel light on purpose, okay? But if the price is right, I'll tell Jed I'm carrying less, so you can carry more. What's your offer? No sweat off my... Well, I grew up near Dayglow out west, so yeah. I grew a third nut that glows in the dark. Nice job, Eagle Eye. Of course I got a pit boy and a vault suit. So what? Where the fuck you think? Vault 22. That's where I grew up. Oh, you've been to Vault 22, huh? I may have been exaggerating a little. Truth is, I got this suit and the pit boy off a dead prospector who came out from Zion. Guy was dead when I found him, okay? Had a ton of shit on him. That's how I know there's good loot in Zion, see? Sorry. The shit I do with it is so far over your head, be wasting my time to put it in words you could understand. Basically, it makes me badass. More badass, I mean. It's totally mind-blowing shit. It ain't just some bracelet. Know what I mean? Jed says it's got maps and shit like that. So that's how I'm gonna guide this caravan where it needs to go. Not that I didn't know all that already. Huh? Of course I noticed. First thing I noticed about you. Me? I'm so used to wearing mine, it's just normal. Don't think you're someone special just because you got one. Go ahead. Your word against mine, fucko. See what happens. Hey, why you gotta go and be like that? Look, this is a sweet gig for me. Don't go fucking it up. What are you after anyways? I travel light on purpose.
Looking to join this caravan, huh? Look to me like you can handle yourself. Earning my keep, Jed hired me on as a caravan guard for this expedition of his. The work suits me. I've tried staying put in one place, but it never works out. Grew up in New Reno, and I couldn't put that snake pit behind me fast enough. Then I wound up wasting the prime of my life playing sheriff in Caliente. Little town north on the 93. Talk about a pain in the ass. You ask me, best to keep moving. At least the scenery changes. Imagine New Vegas if there was no Mr. House-type fella keeping the peace. Then give everybody a gun and a jet addiction. Town's run by a bunch of crime families. No law to speak of. Make trouble and you wind up buried in Golgotha outside town. The scuzz factor's off the charts. Non-stop whoring and drugs. Couldn't walk down the street without getting asked to star in a porn movie. So I got my ass out of there while I still owned it. Guess I figured the answer to every problem was rule of law. Naive, huh? Place lived up to its name, that's for sure. When you got fresh water and a trickle of geothermic power, always be some gang of assholes wants to kill you for it. Spent more years and took more bullets than I care to admit protecting that hellhole from dangers within and without. If it wasn't the 80s or the White Legs raiding, it was someone from town drunk off his ass trying to win an argument with a shotgun. Got tired of shooting the folks I was supposed to protect. So, now I do this. What's the difference? Raiders is raiders. Bunch of them swept into town and dragged off two working girls. Deputies and me gave pursuit, straight into 80s territory. By the time we caught up with the girls, there wasn't much left of them, so we turned for home. Made it back to Caliente without further losses, but we was watched the whole way. Never seen so few people cover so much land. Goddamn creepy. If the 80s had wanted to kill us, we would have been dead. Guess they figured we weren't worth the trouble. Used to be they raided northeast of Caliente time to time. But then the Desert Rangers fell apart 10 years ago, absorbed into the NCR. Soon enough, the White Legs were swarming all over that stretch of I-15. Folks learned not to head north if they wanted to keep their scalps. Eventually, the White Legs destroyed the bridges across the Virgin River over in Arizona. End of discussion. Used to be they raided northeast of Caliente. Soon enough, the White Legs were swarming all over that stretch of I-15. Folks learned not to head north if they wanted to keep their scalps. Eventually, the White Legs destroyed the bridges across the Virgin River over in Arizona. End of discussion. Catch you another time, then.
You seen that tower on the strip all lit up? You can see it for miles.
Are you here to jaw at me a while longer? Are we ready to get this show on the road? Are you here to jump? I don't want no whining about old Mr. Masterson. I left my one-of-a-kind plasma cannon back at base. Can we go back for it? You sure you're ready now? You ain't never been to Zion, have you? We'll be passing through a whole mess of narrow slot canyons and high rough passes. A big pack will get you wedged in like a super mutant crawling through a storm drain, and too much weight will kill you in the thin air. You sure about that this time? Well, all right then. Let's get moving. We got a long road ahead of us. The paths we're following are slow going, so you might as well keep your ears open and listen to what old Jed has to say. A few decades back, folks in the NCR started to hear about a community in northern Utah called New Canaan. Didn't know much about them, except that they were religious folks, sent out missionaries to talk to the tribes. We've seen our share of cults, but the New Canaanites, they were honest traders. Good fighters, too. Raiders wouldn't tangle with them. But then, the Legion appeared in Arizona. I reckon you know all about them. Turns out Caesar's first war chief, the Malpace Legate, was a New Canaanite, Joshua Graham. Legend goes that Graham was the meanest, toughest son of a bitch in the whole damn Legion. The New Canaanites wouldn't talk about him. They were ashamed. Guess I can't blame him. Well, at Hoover Dam, the Malpace Legate finally met his match. Hanlon and Oliver kicked his New Canaanite butt right back over the river. Caesar had to make an example for the others, to show them that even at the highest level, failure wouldn't be tolerated. He had Graham covered in pitch, lit on fire, and thrown into the Grand Canyon. People say he didn't even scream on the way down. Not long after, some of the slaves and tribals started to talk. Said Graham wasn't dead. Shouldn't have been any surprise. All this talk bothered Caesar, so he forbade anyone from speaking his name. Wanted to erase Joshua Graham from history. He got his wish. Joshua Graham disappeared, and in his place came legends of the burned man walking the wastes. Probably just a tribal ghost story. But New Canaan's been silent for a long time. Maybe it's a coincidence. Maybe the Malpace Legate is dead. Or maybe Joshua Graham did crawl out of that canyon and finally found his way back home. All right. people. Been a long couple of weeks. But here we are. Zion. I know your feet hurt. I know you're tired. But I need everyone's mind on the trail ahead.
Ain't the trail ahead worries me, Jed. Those descents we made through that slot canyon back up there. Ain't no way we're getting back out the way we come. And then what?
God damn it, Stella heard you the first time. And the 15th, too. The new Canaanites will know a way. And if they don't, we've got the maps on our friend's Pip-Boy over there. Enough lollygagging. Get moving. And keep an eye out for tribals.
Sorry to bother you with reality, old Jed. Who cares if we can't get back out the way we come? That's not a problem.
ambush! Come! People, watch yourselves!
I don't deserve this! My people are owning the world! How the fuck you hired me?
Shut the hell up, Ricky! Might as well be waving at him!
Hoi, white legs don't leave survivors often. You're some kind of lucky, let me tell you. You came from outside, didn't you? From the civilized lands. Wow. Joshua will want to hear about this. Joshua Graham. He leads our tribe. Thanks to him, the dead horses are strong and safe from our enemies. He'll want to talk to anyone coming up from Southways. Guess that means just you now. Come, I can take you to him. Good sists. We head east then. Joshua is at our tribe's camp in the Eastern Virgin.
See that log over there?
Take a closer look.
Might be some good stuff tucked in there.
We follow this. Nice view of the river. Yeah.
feels good to be doing some actual scouting, not just... Don't have anything as nasty as Yao Guai.
Out where you come from, huh?
Some kind of behavior, eh? How to look. You can spot all kinds of landmarks up here. Look, I'll show you. Thank you.
Feels good to be doing some action.
Headed north,
around this rock pile.
Follow the old road south.
Bet they don't have anything as nasty as Yao Guang, where you come from. I'm happy to travel with you. The spitter plants and the green coastermen aren't native to Zion. You see the dead commons are trapped in them. But Joshua says it shows we're serious about fighting white legs. Back when. Good thing for you, I don't buy into that stuff.